Example 9.15, estimate the value of integral 0 to 0.5 x square into dx by using the Riemann's sum corresponding to 5 sub interval of the equal width and apply. So apply the first end, left end rule, next right end rule, next midpoint of the rule. So first of all, sub interval of the width, so that is to find out the first sub interval of width or equal width. So first the given that the integration, so first of all the given that the solution, first of all the given that the integration 0 to 0.5, next x square into dx, x square into dx. So next one, s equal to 0, the lower limit s equal to 0, next upper limit bc equal to 0.5, bc equal to 0.5. Next n c equal to 5, this is given that n means the total number of the interval, that is n c equal to 5. First to find out the value of sub interval, so the partition of the given interval, the partition, so the given interval, the first to find out the partition of the interval is given below the point, okay, and the next to find out the h value, h is the delta, okay, so delta x is also the h. So h that is equal to h that is equal to delta x is equal to b minus a divided by n, that is equal to b minus a divided by n, okay, next one, b is equal to 0.5 minus 0 whole divided by 5 is equal to 0.5 whole divided by 5 is equal to 0.1, that is the delta x is equal to 0.5. next, to find the partition of the interval, to find the partition of the given intervals, okay, to find the partition of the given intervals, so first to find, let us take the x naught, so x naught is equal to 0, the lower limit x naught is equal to 0. Next to find out the x1 is equal to x0 plus h, that is equal to x0 plus h, that is equal to 0.1, okay, h is going to 0.1, x0 is going to 0. Next to find out the x2, so x2 is equal to x1 plus h, that is equal to this one 0.1, so 0.1 plus 0.1 is equal to 0.2, okay, this one is going to 0.2. next x3 is equal to x2 plus h, x2 0.2 plus 0.1 is equal to 0.3. next x4 that is equal to x3 plus h is equal to 0.3 plus 0.1 is equal to 0.4, okay, the last one x5 is equal to x4 plus h is equal to 0.4 plus 0.1 is equal to 0.5, okay, that is the partition of the interval, partition of the interval. So first, the first left end rule, the first point is left end rule. Left end rule, so s that is equal to f of x0 plus f of x1 plus f of x2, next plus f of x3 plus f of x4, next one delta x, that is the left end rule. So next f of x0, f of x is going to the value is x square, f of x is going to the value is x square, okay, next one. So that is called, this is going to the value is f of into x naught, so x naught is equal to, x naught is equal to 0, next one plus f of x1, x1 is equal to 0.1, next plus f of 0.2, next one plus f of 0.3, next one plus f of 0.4 into delta x means 0.1, so that is equal to f of x, that is equal to f of x is equal to, since f of x is equal to x square, now f of 0 is equal to 0, f of 1 is equal to 1, this one f of 0, this one 0, 0.1, so first one answer 0, next one 0.01, next 0.04, squaring for 0.2, next one plus 0.09 plus 0.16 into 0.1, okay, ma? So that is equal to, adding this term is, so this one 20, 0.25, 25, 29, 30, so 0.30, this one is 0.30, into 0.1, so that is equal to 0.30 into 0.1, that is equal to, the value is 0.03, so is equal to 0.03, that's the s, therefore integral of, the integral of 0 to 0.5 x square dx, that is equal to 0.03, this one left end rule, the first one. So in the next subdivision, second subdivision is going to right end rule. Right end rule. Right end rule. So the form of right hand rule, s that is equal to into f of x1 plus f of x2 plus f of x3 plus f of x4 plus f of x5. Okay, ma? So this one completed to f of 4, this one completed to f of 5 into delta x. So that is equal to into f of x1, x1 is equal to 0.1. So f of 0.1 plus f of into 0.2 plus f of into 0.3 plus f of into 0.4 plus f of into 0.5 into 0.1. So this one f of x. So the given that f of x is equal to x square. So now squaring of this term is 0.01, 0.01 plus 0.04 plus 0.09 plus 0.16, next one 0.25 into 0.1, okay, ma? So is equal to 25, this is also 25, 25 plus 25, 0.05550, next one 0.55, so 0.055 into 0.1 is equal to 0.55, okay, ma? Into 0.55 equal to 0.055. Okay, ma? So therefore integral of 0 to 0.5 into x square dx is approximately 0.055. So next third subdivision, third one to find out the midpoint. So midpoint rule. Third one, midpoint rule. So s that is equal to f of into x0 plus x1 divided by 2 plus into f of into x1 plus x2 divided by 2, next one plus into f of x2 plus x3 divided by 2 plus f of into x3 plus x4 divided by 2, the last one f of x4 plus x5 divided by 2, okay, ba? So this one x0 is going to generally 0 is given, the next x1, so x1 0.1 divided by, x1 is going to 0.1 divided by 2, so that is equal to, this one value is going to 0.05, so the first term s of is equal to f of into 0.05, the first value, next f of into 0.15, next f of into 0.25 plus f of into 0.35, next plus f of into 0.45. So each one find out to the value of this one only. The second term should be x1. x1 is going to 0.1. Next x2. So 0.1, 0.2 divided by 2, we get the solution of 0.15. Okay. So that is equal to f of x. F of x means the given that f of x means x square. That is called 0.05 the whole square. So 0.05 the whole square is equal to 0.0025. Next one plus 0.0225. Next 0.0625. Next plus 0.1225 plus 0.2025. Okay. So this one adding to for all the terms that is equal to we get 0.041. So for adding to for this term fully into 0.1 that is equal to we get 0.041215. So therefore we get the solution integral 0.5 into x square into dx that is equal to 0.04125. We get the approximate value of a midpoint rule.